We are here at the elections of the next hike. I, as the president, the next location of ICAS, and it's a great moment. We just heard presentations by three excellent candidates, by three excellent locations, and I'm looking forward to a great choice.
The challenges were to make sure that social sciences was increasingly visible. We have been fighting this fight for a while, and it's becoming less and less of a fight. People are really realizing that social sciences are really an important part of Arctic sciences. I think this conference really speaks to that, the fact that we're up to 700 people now.
Back then, we had some specific challenges, like IASA was a smaller organization. It was not as well connected in the big science world. We were the outsiders. We had not really yet a seat at the table.
Having the Congress in Nuuk was a logistical challenge in many ways. Air Greenland earlier had a connection between Baltimore in the US and Kangerlussuaq in Greenland and to Nuuk. Less than half a year before the Congress, that route was cancelled. So we had to reschedule all our North American visitors.
The main thing you do as president is you hold the Congress, and it's like sort of like a wedding where you have all your friends come and then you don't have any time to talk with them, but it's very exciting. The other thing, it gives you opportunities. I ended up talking to a lot of embassies in Europe about the importance of social sciences.
In 2004, climate change just appeared somewhat on the horizon, and so I think this new relevance of the Arctic also brings a lot of responsibility for us.
Climate change is important, but it's got a social dimension, and there's other social issues that are really even more important to some people in the Arctic. And getting that message out so that policymakers could start thinking about those things, it's a very important part. And I think people, and including our natural science and physical sciences colleagues, are realizing that you can talk about ocean acidification or permafrost degradation, but what you're really interested in those issues is their impact on people.
Why do we need the social sciences in the Arctic? And I actually would turn the question around and say, you know, how could there be science without people? There cannot be. It needs to be done with people and about people. Otherwise, there is no research, there is no science.
To announce that the next president of IASA is Andrej Petkov. And Andrej, yes, my presentation.
Well, my immediate reaction expressed with one word should be relief, because 3 years is a long time, and I must admit, much more work than I ever expected when we started this 3 years ago.
It's a difficult shoes to feel. I mean, especially Peter and Gail, before Peter and John and the other Peter, you know, Ivan Swan. I mean, it's a lot of great organizers, great scientists. So it's a little bit intimidating for me in some way.
We are now 800 participants, which is almost the double size of this conference has ever been before. We have doubled the activities on social media, and we have seen how social sciences and humanities has grown into a much more important player in the Arctic context than before.
Over the last three decades, social sciences achieved tremendous growth and prominence in some ways within the family of Arctic sciences. If we go back just to maybe mid-90s or early 2000s, we were just sort of stepchildren in some ways of other Arctic scientists that were invited whenever we need it for some reason. The international polar year of 2007 to 2008 changed that a lot.
We totally acknowledge the importance of natural sciences and climate change research. That is so important and so necessary, but it's not everything.
And since then, it's really just 10, 15 years, we undertook jump in respect to importance, but also in respect to appreciation of what social sciences could bring to the family of science, but also the communities.
There is a need in this region to have a sustainable development and a positive development in terms of social aspects, economic aspects, demographic, cultural, language. The list can be long.
And I think that's why we are in this critical juncture when IASA has grown a lot, But now we need to step in to make sure that we are central organization for all Arctic, not only social sciences, but we are understood and considered as a voice in Arctic sciences family.
This is the message that we try to spread in as many occasions as possible.
It's a huge event. It's a tremendously successful event. 800 participants, you know, something that in my time we were happy to have half of the people.
We're growing quickly. We're going to have to formalize the institution a little bit more. We've had a fairly loose bottom-up organization, and we're going to have to start putting a few more, you know, organizational structures in place.
Well, you could see the need of social science and the need of social scientists working together is obvious, and it is sort of illustrated in also the development of the number of people attending the ICASs.
It's certainly not that just size is itself something to rest upon. It's really the kind of where to go in the next 3 years, in the next 10, in the next 20 years.
But with a number of participants between 700 and 800 like we have here, it'll be impossible for smaller cities and settlements in the Arctic to have that many people.
But that's a good challenge. It's a really positive challenge.
Accepting more members to your family is not a danger, but it's a challenge. In the next 2 years, we have to also go through the pains of change in the sense that becoming more mature, larger association. So, but I think it's a good thing. It's a, you know, it's a growth, and growth is important because, you know, well, for IASA, the growth is mostly coming from engaging more younger scientists, early career scientists, which is actually our goal.